Hello, everyone. My name is Eric Jones, and I am the turf teacher. And I would like to thank you for joining me in this presentation entitled Green Industry Social Media. Now, before we get started, let's talk a little about the page here that I have up with the six social media icons. Hopefully that you recognize them. It's possible. But if you don't, that's A-okay. We're going to talk a little bit about each, and we're going to talk more in depth about Facebook, a little bit about Twitter, and some things about LinkedIn in this presentation. But these are the six main ones, and I hope to have a lecture on how to use all of these coming up in the next several months. I've already got the Snapchat one done. It's a great presentation. Just showing you how Snapchat can be used in landscaping, in irrigation, in any type of green industry business. Everything that we do is very visual, and that's what we want to do. We want to show clients what we do. But the six icons here, the first one with the little play button is YouTube. The video that you're watching right now is a YouTube video. I use YouTube to present all of my lectures. It puts them out there online. It puts, I can make them private, unprivate, or even unpublished. You guys would want everything to be public. You want to see everything that you're doing. You want your clients, potential clients, to know exactly what you're doing. I've seen guys YouTube themselves mowing, or have one of their clients, or not one of their clients, but one of their employees, YouTubing them mowing and putting in nice stripes in the yard. I mean, it's a cool little marketing feature. But YouTube is great for videos. It's great for messaging, sending out a quick video message. Hey, clients, just want to let you know that we've opened up a new section in our business. We're going to start a holiday and event decorating side. We're going to be installing Christmas lights this year. You know, if you want to get on the list or take a look at it, please go to our website and check us out on social media. You know, send that out. Send your YouTube out. Best thing about social media, and people are often thinking, well, it takes way too much time to do this. You're absolutely wrong. It takes very little time to do this. You can do a quick, short little YouTube video like that, and then it'll post to Facebook. You can post it to Twitter. You can post it to Instagram. All this stuff is interconnected, or you can set them up to be interconnected. So you do it with one thing, then you can send it to all of them. Now, not all of them will work like that, but most of them will. But YouTube is that first one, that little white bird in the blue box is Twitter. I think Twitter is probably more important for us on the business-to-business side, kind of like LinkedIn, that if we use this to communicate with other professionals in the industry. Yes, a lot of our clients are on it. A lot of the professionals are on Twitter, and you'll see that. It's more of a business-to-business thing. That's how I like using it. I like talking to the guys down in Texas. I like talking to the guys in Florida. What are they doing in their landscape business? And we communicate back and forth through Twitter. Short, simple little, it's like a little text message that gets posted to your Twitter page. And then everybody follows your feed, can see what you're doing and what's going on. The little box here with the camera in it is Instagram. Now, Instagram is good because, again, it's a visual application. You take a picture, you post it to your Instagram page, and you can put a little text or a little typing underneath it describing what you are doing. So Instagram is for that. LinkedIn, again, more business-to-business communication. Networking, perfect place to network, perfect place to do all that. I'm on LinkedIn. I don't use it like I should, but I feel like I need to concentrate my marketing on other things. But LinkedIn is good. I do get messages and answer questions through that, so it's not a bad way to go. But my favorite of all of them is the little ghost there, and that's Snapchat. And I've already done a one-hour lecture on that. But Snapchat has the perfect camera app, takes really good pictures. You can add the text. You can send it to a bunch of people or post it to your story or send it to individuals. It can also be used for actually text messaging. If you don't want people knowing your phone number, you can give them your Snapchat handle, and you can text that way. And then last but not least is Facebook. It has been a very important aspect of our business, especially on the strawberry farm. People come out, pick their berries, they're taking pictures of their little ones, they're posting it to Facebook, and they're tagging us, and it's just a continual drive of customers out to the strawberry patch based on us having just the page. We're not really having to post much to it because the customers that come and pick the strawberries, they're the ones posting all this material. They're tagging us in it, and it's getting sent out to everybody. And then next thing you know, we got people driving an hour to get to our strawberry farm. So it's worked out great. But these six right here that I've got on the title page, I believe are the most important that we need to do. LinkedIn, the IN, and the Twitter. Let's concentrate on that. Maybe use it more for networking. And again, you've heard me say it multiple times if you've taken my class before. We do not network as an industry, and it drives me crazy. Guys, I don't look at you as my competitor. I look at you as my colleagues. I look at you as my peers. I look at you as my brothers and sisters out here in the same business that we love. We do what we do because we love it. I mean, it's hard work. You have to love it to want to get into it. And so why are we not sitting down at the dinner table at least once a month in our community, and several of us landscape contractors getting together and networking and talking about what we need to do for our area? Yeah, it's hard to control what's going on at the coast or in the mountains. I'm in the central, I'm in the Piedmont. I'm in the Triad, Winston-Salem. So why can't I get together with other landscape contractors from the area and we talk about what we're doing? You know, what we're charging. Everybody, we need to be on the same page, and we need to network, and we can use the social media to do it. Not only can we market to potential and existing clients, but we can communicate back and forth with each other and do what we need to do. Bring this industry together. So what is social media? Social media are the various forms of user-generated content, meaning us producing images and text that we're sending out. And it's a collection of websites and applications that enable people to interact and share information online. I love that. We're communicating with our clients without talking to them. Some of you may not want to deal with people or talk to people, but using social media, you're still getting your message across. People are still able to contact you. You're not having to do this. You know, you're actually communicating via pictures, via snaps, via text messaging on your post, your tweets, your videos. You're getting your message across, and people are knowing who you are. So some of the social networking sites, primarily Facebook's probably the biggest one right now. I think Snapchat's gonna close in on that pretty quick. And then Twitter and LinkedIn. Again, Twitter and LinkedIn, more colleague to colleague, peer to peer, contractor to contractor. Let's use that. Let's communicate, guys. Blogs, WordPress. I love blogging. Blogging does take some time, though. And it's better not to have any of these social media sites than to have them and not use them or produce content daily, at least weekly. I like to do something every day. I try to. Now, the ones that, of you that are following me on the site may notice that I haven't posted, or I'm a few far in between, especially on Turf Teacher. That's because I am still communicating with you through email, sending you information about the class. But I need to really pump up the Turf Teacher, and I have a lot more plans other than continue ed with the company. So I need to start using my social media for that. But blogs, back to blogging. Blogging is writing. You got to sit down and kind of write. But the good thing about it, it's free information for your clients. People want to subscribe to your blog because they want to see what you know up here. You're the green industry expert. You're the horticulturalist. You're the landscape contractor. You're the irrigation contractor. You're the certified plant professional. You're the certified arborist. You're the landscape architect. You are the experts in your field. People want to know what's up here. And if you give your clients a little bit of information, they're going to hire you. There's an insect. It's taking over, eating shrubs. You go out and you take a picture of it, put it on your sites. Hey, this is the such and such insect. It will destroy your plant and blah, blah, blah. It's going to get those clients going outside looking. Oh, we've got the same thing. We've got this. Honey, you need to call Turf Teacher tomorrow when you get to work. Have him come out and take a look at it, and let's get rid of these bugs. Again, free information brought them to my, me giving the free information brought them to my sites, made them pick up the phone. Well, what if they didn't call me? They're still going out and they see those bugs eating those plants. I throw up a 10% coupon. Now that kind of gets them going. They keep coming back to my sites because I'm giving them a little bit of free information. Then I can throw up some advertising. Video sharing. YouTube. Just talked about that. Love YouTube. I don't know if you guys have seen my horse head mowing video that's on YouTube. I'm wearing the horse head mask, riding the turf tiger. I love that. And it was basically just striping the yard wearing a horse head. Photo sharing, Flickr. Flickr's good because we not only need the cell phones for cameras, but guys, it's a-okay to have like a nice camera to go out and take like portfolio size pictures of our projects. Take that little card out of the camera, boom, upload it to Flickr, and you've got those pictures forever. And they're on the cloud, you're not going to lose them. And people can go to your Flickr site and see like an entire project. So it's really, really cool to use that. User reviews such as Amazon and Yelp, people commenting or talking about you as your business, we probably start need to using these more. I know I need to. I need to get involved more with these two myself. And then messaging such as Snapchat. And you know that I'm a big proponent of Snapchat. For one, my kids got me introduced to it. I communicate with them through Snapchat and through FaceTime. That's the only thing they're going to answer. They're not going to answer a text message. They're definitely not going to answer a phone call, but they will snap me back. So that's one way I keep in touch with it. And I love going out and taking pictures, of a monarch butterfly that's, on a flowering shrub. Post it to my story, and then you see who's liked it. Save that picture, then post it to Facebook, which in return sends it to Twitter, which in turn sends it to Instagram, and vice versa. It's so cool. Doing that, and it's really quick and simple. I've put up some information and I've put up stuff that people want to see, so they keep coming back to my sites. Or when they're scrolling through their feed, they're like, ah, oh, Eric took a picture of that butterfly, that is so gorgeous. Well, what shrub is that? They start investigating, but then they send me a text, or they send me an email, or they send me a snap. We'll respond to that snap. Eric, what shrub is that? I would love to have that in my yard. Well, it's such and such. We can have it to you tomorrow if you'd like. Guys, the possibilities are limitless when it comes to social media, and we need to start using it. Again, the free information gets them coming back. Now, what I want you to do, I'm going to play this YouTube video. Now, this is probably the first time I've tried bringing in a video to the screen, so let's see how it works. Make sure that I am connected to the internet. And this should open up Internet Explorer for me, YouTube. And make sure the volume is up. I'm gonna full screen it for you guys. But this is the social media revolution. It's a cool video, and you can find it on YouTube. Again, I can't tell you how much I love this video. Pumps me up, gets me excited about doing the social media. And if that doesn't get you pumped up for creating social media sites for your business, I don't know what will. Again, the return on investment is that your company will still exist in 5 years. We all plan to be in business 5 years, right? Word of mouth can only take us so far. Now, if you're a one-man operator or one-man or one-woman show, yes, word of mouth is good. I have students that graduate the program. They go out. They have themselves, maybe one employee, and all they use is word of mouth. And still, word of mouth is probably the best advertisement you'll ever get, but that word of mouth can become that world of mouth. People like to talk. People like to brag. You do a nice job for them, they're going to put it on Facebook. Then they're going to say, who did that for you? And then they're going to say, turf teacher did it. And then I'm going to get that job. So guys, you got to use it. Please use it. And that's hopefully what this lecture is going to inspire you guys to do. And so why is social media necessary for us, the green industry? We can find customers. We want to do that, right? We can find customers. The least expensive way is through social media. Social media doesn't cost you a thing. I mean, yes, you can pay for more optimization and putting your stuff out there, but you don't necessarily have to because the free parts work just as well. What is the public saying about you? You want to know. You know, I want to hear what people are saying about me. And you'll see that. Now, guys, I've had some bad reviews pop up. I've had some of my YouTube videos. This is a YouTube video that you're watching. You know, people putting, you know, this is kind of blah. Or I have people saying, thank you, that was good information. I've had people as far as, you know, this, in Africa, putting comments on my videos saying, thank you. Where can I find more information about this? It's a wonderful way to get the word out. It can introduce your brand. But what is your brand? What is it? What is it that makes you unique from everybody else? Tell the world. Get feedback. You can put out little surveys. You can put out little questionnaires. Hey, what would you like to see? What would you like to see us do as a company? Is there a service that you've been looking for? You know, we're thinking about expanding the business. Tell us what you think. Get that feedback. Test your audience. You've got a new product. You've got a new service that you're offering. You know, ask your followers, hey, what do you think about this? They're going to tell you. They're going to let you know. And it solidifies you as a green industry expert. You know, you are the expert. And, you know, we all fight that stigma, like, you know, hey, he's a grass cutter. You know, no, I cut grass, but I'm first and foremost a landscape contractor. I'm first and foremost an irrigation contractor. I'm a certified plant professional. I'm this, I'm that. I have these licenses. I have this certification. I've made a career out of this. I've made a lifetime out of the green industry. So don't tell me that I'm a grass cutter. But yes, I cut grass. I love cutting grass. Monotonous work makes money. Grass cutting has paid my bills since I was 7, 8 years old. Mom and dad always, very few times that we could stay after school and play sports. You know, mom and dad were picking us up, taking us to a job site. And every summer, I ran a push mower. And then I was old enough, or my dad thought I was strong enough, he put me on a weed eater and he bought me a little curved shaft one because the straight shafts were just too big for me. So he bought me the smallest little curved shaft weed eater and I did that all summer. But you know something? When I got to high school, and I was like, "Mom, Dad, I'd like to buy a car. You know, is there any way you could pay us for this work that we've been doing?" Me and my brother thought we was just doing it for free. I mean, we didn't have no idea. Well, Dad's like, "Well, son, you got enough money to go out and we can look for a car." And I'm like, "What do you mean?" He's like, "Well, son, you've worked for me for how many summers? And all these afternoons, your mama's picked you up and brought you to where I was." He said, "We wrote you a check. We just deposited in a savings account." So I had enough money to go and buy me a little Subaru while I was in high school when I turned 16. Thought that was the greatest thing in the world. So again, solidify you as the green industry expert. You already are. Just make it known that you are. Again, that free information that you put on these social media sites. Sorry if I get off on a tangent sometimes. I do get a little crazy. Even my students at the college say that. Hey, let's do a brainstorm. I want you to think about hashtags. Take out a quick sheet of paper. Scratch paper, napkin, whatever you're at, wherever you're watching this video, write down some single words that describe your landscape or irrigation business. What is it that makes you you? What about the title of it, the area that you live in? What's unique about it? Do you have a unique name? What is it that makes your company cool? Hashtag it. Think about it. Write down these words. That can be your social media handles. Like I'm Turf Teacher on all the social media sites. And I'll tell you how I come up with that. I sat down just like I did. I brainstormed, wrote down a piece of paper. And I kind of thought of Turf Teacher to begin with. Wrote it down. I wrote down like plant professor. I wrote down landscape lecturer. I wrote down irrigation professor, irrigation instructor. Was thinking of everything that I do and wrote them down. And then I went to GoDaddy.com. And I found out that turfteacher.com was available. Some of the other ones weren't available. And so the website that was available, I put a check mark for them, crossed out the ones that the websites wasn't available. And then went to the social media sites, entered it, tried creating it, made sure that turf teacher or plant professor or landscape lecturer made see if all of them were available. Well, there's just a couple that had the website and the handle name for all the social media sites. One of them was Turf Teacher. I really liked Plant Professor to begin with and thought about that, but I couldn't find the social medias for it. Somebody had already had it. So I went with Turf Teacher, and that's really, to be honest with you, more of what I do. It's what I do at the school. So Turf Teacher became my website, became my social media, became everything for me. And it was by just jotting down these ideas, that little notebook, writing it down, scratch paper, writing it down. And coming up with these catchy phrases that becomes your marketing piece. All right, so let's go ahead and start talking a bit about Facebook. Now, I did. You heard me earlier mention that my little girls, got 4 daughters and a boy. They don't like Facebook, but they're young. They're like, "Mom, Dad, Facebook's for old people." Well, I'm not old, and I love Facebook, and my parents love Facebook. In-laws, they're a little bit into it. Not, you know, if they do it, they're going to get out their iPad and do it. They're not going to do it on their phone or anything. They're going to sit down either at the computer or on the couch with a nice iPad, you know, sit there at the end of the day and kind of check it. My dad, he checks it at night. I can tell when dad's home, finally finished from working, because I can see him liking my post at night. So I can tell when he's home because he sits there and does it in his office at the house on the computer. But Facebook is very good. You know, you saw in the video that the largest segment growing is, you know, women, what, 55 to 65, something like that. Well, those are the clients that we want, right? So we got to use Facebook. But if we're wanting to go after these young millennials or whatever, you know, we need to do Snapchat and Instagram because they're more into that. I just told you, my kids don't like Facebook. They'll probably never ever get into Facebook. And by the time they get old enough, or my age, there's probably going to be another social media app that's come out and kind of overtakes that. But why Facebook? According to a recent report by the Mercant Circle, 70% of businesses use Facebook. It's a 20% increase over last year. For the first time ever, Facebook is being used more than Google for online marketing. Facebook updates are three More times effective than tweets to propel online business. And again, I believe that because what did I say I like using Twitter for? I like using it for peer-to-peer or contractor-to-contractor communication. The guys we buy our fertilizer and seed from, I love reading their tweets. Lawn Care Millionaire down in Dallas, Texas. Love that guy. Get all his tweets, subscribe to his YouTube feed, watch him, get a lot of information from that. It's a real, real, real sharp individual down there. I'd love to meet him one day. And then Facebook dominates the check-in space with 32% of businesses using this feature. I do that all the time. I do that all the time. Everybody's like, Eric, we know where you're at. I'm like, why? Because you're on Facebook. You post it to Facebook. Well, I'm like, I like letting people know. I went to Rinalda Gardens today. I, tag Rinalda Gardens and I take a picture of it because guess what it did? It just showed that I'm out in my community. I'm out doing something, visiting a beautiful place that Winston-Salem has. And I want my clients and I want my potential clients to see that I'm out and about. And back to that check-in. That works so well with us at the Strawberry Patch. People would come out to the farm and they would tag Jones Strawberry Farm. Take a picture of that little girl, a little boy eating the strawberry dripping down their little chin, and they got the little red stain on their shirt. They're holding our basket in a little pail and they're eating that strawberry. Mom and dads love that. They Facebook it. They tag us, it picks up their location. Next thing you know, we got people saying, "Well, we saw this on Christie's page this morning, and we didn't even know you guys were here." But it worked. They came, they picked berries. So with Facebook, create the page using the name, logo, and branding. Again, I found that Turf Teacher was available. I snagged it. Use it as an outlet to display and share information in a fun, informal way in conjunction with your website. Now, with Facebook, guys. On a business side, to create that business page, you first got to have that personal page. And I told you, as a business owner, people want to know what the business owner is doing as well as what the company's doing. So have the personal page, have the business page, which is tied to your personal page, and then you can make like your secretary or somebody else. An admin of the page once it's created. And once you get so many followers and stuff, that's when you can name it. It took me a couple days to be able to name mine facebook.com/turfteacher because I had to have so many likes and so many people. But that's quick. You use that personal page and say, hey, like this page. This is what I'm doing. You get several friends and family to like it. You've named it. You're able to brand that name and that logo to a Facebook page. You can form relationships with people in your industry. And your clients' clients. What works good with that is you're taking care of a site that's gorgeous. You tag them. Hey, we just mowed landscape site number one. I'm not gonna name anything, but one of your more prominent clients. Well, guess who sees that? Well, other people that they work with and their clients are like, wow, Eric does that. Eric just did that this morning. I need to give him a call. So it's back and forth, guys. The possibilities are limitless. And you can showcase the real side of your business. People also kind of want to see behind the scenes. How many times do you stay after the movie to see the bloopers? You like seeing the actors and actresses cut up and have a good time making the movie. Well, sometimes people want to see, hey, what's it like to be a landscape contractor? Do they ever know? No, they don't. For one, they think you're cutting grass because that's the only thing you can do. But on the other hand, they think you make all this money, right? It's two different ends of the spectrum. No, they want to see that we're professionals. They want to see that. They want to see that office. They want to see us getting there at 6 o'clock in the morning. On my personal Facebook page, people send me there like, Eric, we love your Monday motivations. I mean, I do. I wake up Monday is my favorite day. I post something to Facebook all the time about. Stop complaining that it's Monday. It's a new week. It's a new beginning. This might be the week or the day that hard work crosses paths with good luck. And that's when you really, really make it. The best thing can happen on a Monday. It's the newest day of the week. Go for it. People are like, they'll text me and they'll message me back on Facebook. They're like, we love your motivation. We love your Monday motivations. And that's showing the real side of me. That's showing my personality. Again, here's my Facebook. I screenshotted this a while back. Before I did the class in Raleigh. I did it back at the end of March. I was at the Hampton Inn. I took a picture of the outside hotel, inside the conference room. And I thought it was cool because we was near PNC Arena. They had this like guy dressed in Wolfpack gear standing in the phone booth. But it's, stuff like that that I post to my Facebook. And what should you talk about on Facebook? You should talk about everything. Again, everything. What is your company doing? Give them that free information. Talk about what needs to be done in the garden. We're landscape contractors, but people still might want a garden. They want that little bit of information. They're like, well, he's a horticulturalist. He's also a landscape contractor. He knows his stuff, or she knows her stuff. Put that information out there. Get them coming back. You've sponsored the kids' Little League team. You're sponsoring the Tigers at Northwest Forsyth Little League. Let people know. Put it on Facebook and tag them. You're giving back to the community. Everybody wants to see a company giving back to the community. And we should. But ideas, news, is there anything going on internally worth sharing? Is there any upcoming events? Did you hire someone new? Is there any announcements? Is one of your employees getting married? Brag about that. Be proud of them. Let them know that, hey, they're starting their family. They're becoming, starting out in their career. They're young, anything like that. People want to hear it. People like hearing good stuff, believe it or not. We turn the TV on and everything on the news is bad news, So be that light in their day and talk about some good stuff. Industry trends, news, what's the current trend? New posts, they can be funny, shocking, serious, entertaining. Makes you look like an expert. I try to make everything I say funny. Sometimes it backfires, but I do at least give it a shot. Client news, great way to promote upcoming client events and campaigns. Let people know who you're working with and for whom. You went out and, we do Carolina Farm Credit. We mow that up in Rural Hall in North Carolina. They have a big field day. Hey, put it on the Facebook page. Hey, just got this place in shape, pruned the shrubs, put out fresh needles, got the grass looking good for their big field day. Congrats, Farm Credit. Thanks for being our client. And, we love being one of their clients. I mean, if it weren't for them, there have been times they give us money when we needed it. But then past achievements. What were some of your greatest accomplishments? Brag about yourself. Again, on social media, guys, it's okay to brag a little bit. You want to promote yourself. And this is the legal way to do it that doesn't make you look cocky and arrogant. So your URL, again, mine was facebook.com turf teacher. You need to kind of think of facebook.com, whatever it is. That's why I wanted you to brainstorm and write down those names. What is it that describes you? Who are you? What do you do? What can set you apart? Now, again, I wanted my website and I wanted all of my social media sites to have the same name. So turfteacher.com was available. And then Turf Teacher on Twitter, YouTube, Facebook, Instagram, all that was available. So I locked them down, and that's how I became the Turf Teacher. I wanted everything the same. I had my students in the marketing and management class. We sat down, and we did that for my dad's company. The name of his company is Elite Landscape Service Incorporated. Well, Elite Landscape Service, Inc. is too long to have as a website, too long to have as a social media handle. So we sat down and we brainstormed. I said, get out a sheet of paper, write this down, come up with different things. Found the Facebook. They went back to the computers, went to GoDaddy and see if their website that they had come up with, was it available? Well, then they started going with the social media, is it available? And what they came up for him and dad liked it was Elite Turfscapes. That's the website, that's all of his social media handles. Even though the name of the company is Elite Landscape Service Inc., Elite Turfscapes is his website and his social media handles, and we market that. And people realize that. They realize that Elite Turfscapes is Elite Landscape Service Incorporated. But we wanted that same unique name for everything. And I highly, highly recommend that. And you put that on everything. On the tailgate of your truck, on the back area behind the back wheel in between the brake light, put your social media symbols, and if it's all the same thing, you can just put at Turf Teacher, and then I have the Twitter logo, the YouTube logo, all that. When people see that going by, I've actually been in a restaurant and come out, and I've seen people taking pictures The information is on my truck. I know they're taking that information back home, so hopefully they can give me a call. Share your business on Facebook with your friends, coworkers, and other Facebook users. Let them know that you're in business. And it increases your SEO, your search engine optimization, when people enter your business or name on Google, Yahoo, or similar search engine sites. You want that to increase. You want people to find you. 550 million people on Facebook. Make a first impression. A snapshot of your business and what it's all about. If you do a welcome page, 40% of the users will follow our page versus 23%. Do that welcome page, and Facebook can show you how to do that once you create the page. It's a little different on the business side of it. Once you create that business page, it looks a little bit different than on your personal side. And then show people who you are in about 5 to 10 seconds with a landing page. This could even be where you post that YouTube video. Hey, I'm Eric with Turf Teacher. I do landscape contractor CEUs and green industry consulting. You know, take a look at our website. Here's my Facebook page. You know, have a good day. Customize it. Custom tabs, events, what's new, the type of work we do. If you have a mailing list to do it. I remember my mom was so big on us doing our monthly newsletter. This was before social media. I mean, I was just out of college, you know, late 90s. We did a newsletter called Elite Echoes that we sent out with the billing every month, and she'd be on it. Get that done. Now I could have done it so quickly on social media. Add photos and videos of your staff at work, around the community. Again, I've talked about it. Go to the conference. Take a picture at the Green and Grow Show. Take a picture of going to get your Con Ed hours at other sites. Other places, let people know that you're involved in this industry. And if you take a picture of you doing your CEUs, if you come to one of my face-to-face classes, take a picture. Hey, I'm here on a Saturday getting the hours I need to be that licensed professional to work in, to do the work for you. I'm taking the initiative to be professional. Let people know. Then upload and reach potential contacts using your email lists. Tagging your clients you work for, the organizations you're a part of, and businesses you're interested in. Provide links to your homepage, Twitter, LinkedIn, YouTube, etc., and update daily. Do that. Again, a little bit of information goes a long ways, ladies and gentlemen. It's better to not have it than to have it and not use it. So make sure you use it very, very wisely and that you use it daily. If not, at least weekly, because people kind of get accustomed to it. If you post something every Monday, they're kind of going to get used to that, and they're going to go back. If you start not posting on Monday where you've been posting every Monday, then they're going to be like, well, are they out of business? There again, there's my Facebook. And, whoops, Lord have mercy, went too fast there. But it is Turf Teacher. You know, got the big banner. I actually hired somebody to create my logo and to do this stuff for me. I love the graphic arts, but it's a little hard and it's not much time. Again, you know, that's just the page that I had. The voice of Facebook, establishing yourself as an expert in the field is crucial, especially when promoting your business via social media. Build trust and credibility among followers and online users. In the future, they will come to rely on you when issues arise or they need help with the project. Provide valuable content to online audiences and often seeing industry news, upcoming events, and IGS day-to-day occurrences. Be enthusiastic and conversational and promote your culture. I don't have a problem with being enthusiastic. You know, I've been told I have way too much energy. I get maybe 4 or 5 hours of sleep a night. I wake up every morning at 4:45. I'm ready to go. I'm ready to do this thing because I love what I do. And I let people know it via Facebook. Monday motivation, right? Facebook in the news. Barcelona midfield star Lionel Messi racked up 6.8 million fans 7 hours after setting up a Facebook page. It kind of sounds like me, doesn't he, right? Only kidding. But 7 hours, he had 6.8 million followers or fans on his Facebook page. Unreal. Unreal. Yet, he's not the biggest one on Facebook. The most popular person on Facebook in America in 2016 was Shakira. I never really knew she made you want to dance like this, right? But you know, very, very popular. You know, a few years ago, it was Eminem. So, you know, it'll be somebody different in 2017. And it'll be nice to see who that is. But again, Facebook, it's out there. Use it. Now, we'll talk a little bit about Twitter. Again, I want to use it, and I'm primarily going to use it for peer-to-peer, contractor-to-contractor communication in what's going on. Promote your mission and culture. Twitter is a place to connect with niche audiences pertinent to your business. Again, people in the same industry. It's just probably going to be hard. I don't know. I don't see the stay-at-home mom who can afford landscape services want to follow you on Twitter. Yeah, probably on Facebook. You know, but tweets, you know, you can put an image, you can put a video, but tweets are primarily like a text message. So, you know, I could see them following, you know, fashion and beauty and what's happening on their favorite, you know, television shows. But I like it. I want to see what my landscape buddies are doing, my landscape peers. What are they doing? Twitter is the place to connect with niche. Well, just read that. And then have conversations, build relationships with individuals in your industry and clients too. Now, there's going to be other professionals in similar industries that will want to follow you, and you may want to follow them. Accountants, attorneys, you know, marketing people, anything of that nature, it's good to connect with them on Twitter. Monitor your competition. Who are they following? Who's following them? And what are they up to? Be that investigator. See what's going on. You know, anytime you have to do a marketing plan, you're supposed to do a market analysis and actually see what your competitors are doing. One way to see what they're doing is to follow them on social media. Again, you know, you guys kind of think that we are competitors or there's competition amongst us. And again, I'll stress to you, I'm not in competition with you guys. I'm your peers. I'm your colleagues. You know, I'm your brother. I'm your, you know, you guys are my brothers and sisters. We're out there doing this together. And I wish that everybody could look at that. But if you do have some enemies out there or you don't see it the way I see it, the one way to see what your competition is doing is to follow them on social media. What do you tweet about? Again, industry news can range from shocking to funny, serious, and hard-hitting. Upcoming events, upcoming client events, great way to promote what they're doing. It promotes their images and makes your business look good because you're bragging about other businesses. Now, it lets people know who you are working with. Then day-to-day, great outlet to showcase your company culture. Did something funny happen at the office? Is someone winning an award? Tweeting is all about being conversational. It's about communicating. It's about talking. Now, guys, and I'm guilty of what I'm about ready to say. Sometimes as business owners, we have to bite our tongue, right? We shouldn't talk about politics. We shouldn't talk about other things. But me being prior military and still current, you know, Army Reserve, I've been in the military since 1992, you know, I did have a break in service for a little bit, but was, you know, active Navy, Navy Reserve, then got out and then joined Army Reserve. So I had a lot of, you know, happiness about me. You know, I get excited around elections. I get excited around things like that. And I shouldn't express that because I definitely don't want to lose a client because of how they voted or because of how I voted. It's really none of their business, but it's hard for me to do that. And but we got to be careful what we say. We got to be careful what we say on social media because it's out there. Tweets from landscapers. I mean, look at this guy right here. This is the turf teacher. You know, took a picture of doing the business motivation course on March 25th in Winston-Salem. Took a picture and I tweeted it. You know. Let people know what I'm doing and where I was at. And here's hashtag, good examples of hashtags. Well, this course was worth 7 hours for people that attended. And I hashtagged NCLCLB, North Carolina Landscape Contractor Licensing Board. And whether or not it was a hashtag already created or if it was, it would do it. And when you go to Twitter and you click or you type in NCLCLB, with the hashtag in front of it, it'll pull up every picture that every single body that's put that on their picture. So somebody else can use that hashtag on one of their pictures and it puts it there. Same thing with NCICLB and NCUs. That's what I was doing. I was given 7 hours for both landscape and irrigation contractors board, and you were getting CEUs. So it's one way to put information out there for everybody. Quest Irrigation. Are you looking for a watering system that does not waste water? Boom. Hashtag drip irrigation is what you're looking for. And then you put like this little link there. It looks like a video. All right. Landscape open now. Spring is here and I'm so excited I wet my plants. A good, catchy, funny sign that somebody put up, and they put that up. And it says, you know, this was John Mawson by Buy Irrigation. Thank you, Blowin' 63, for finding this little beauty. It has made our Monday morning. Irrigation, you know, he's hashtagging irrigation, landscaping, gardening, and Monday motivation. Somebody else with Monday motivation, right? You know? I think all of us in the green industry can be motivators if we want. LinkedIn. Now, I'm not going to talk so much about this as I did Facebook, but LinkedIn is a good thing for peer-to-peer. We're going to use it for information and contacts. Do we need more effective solution on business projects or needs? Who can get the job done effectively? You know, it's a professional network introducing yourself. Competitive Edge is a great place to bounce new ideas and get the reaction of professionals in the same industry or even people outside the industry. Get an honest opinion of your business and also on the competition. Throw something out there. Throw an idea out there. You may get an attorney or an accountant or something on there to give you some advice and say, hey, you know, maybe we ought to do it this way. And they're going to probably use it as a sales pitch to get you into their office. But, you know, valuable information can be exchanged through LinkedIn. And these are trusted contacts, and that's what we need. When you're introduced to a contact with one of your trusted connections, you start the working relationship at a far better point than when you hire someone off the street. LinkedIn, you can quickly check references and interact with people who have may provided a prospective employee a recommendation. So it is, and you actually recommend your peers and everything on that. Or if, you know, somebody puts their start date at a company, it reminds you and you can congratulate them. Hey, congratulations on being there 2 years, 3 years, or whatever. Groups allows the members the opportunity to create and manage focus groups on a wide range of business topics. I mean, like education, healthcare, event planning, medicine, blogging, landscaping, horticulture, irrigation. A lot of this stuff can be on there. And then groups offer valuable networking opportunities. Hence, what I've always been talking about, and linking professionals to resources and information that can be beneficial to their missions. Blogging. All right, so what is a blog? Well, in my personal opinion, it is information that you are sending to people. It is you're writing. You're basically a writer. So if you're not a good writer, I wouldn't recommend doing this. But if you have the time and you are a good writer, it's a great way to put out that little bit of free information. When I say writing, guys, we're not writing a book. You may be writing a couple paragraphs on something or an issue that's happening in landscape. You know, we just saw on the tweet back there about drip irrigation. Type up a little article about drip irrigation, your experience with it, and how much water it saves, and, you know, that it's better to place the water exactly where the plant needs it. You know, doing stuff like that. You're giving clients, potential clients, and the general public a little bit of free information that's going to make the phone ring. Because I guarantee you guys, you start talking about things like this, and it's probably going to be, you know, the wife of the family that's probably going to read it. Husband's going to get home, and she's going to be like, we need some drip irrigation. Why? Well, I read about it on such and such blog. Okay, well, you know, maybe he tries it, maybe he not, maybe he doesn't. But the fact is, something's getting done, and I guarantee you, he's just going to be like, call whoever you read that about, see if they can do it, because this Saturday, I'm going to be playing golf, or I'm taking y'all to the beach. We're going to be doing something. I've worked, not that you haven't worked, honey, but let's go do something fun, and let's get this drip irrigation installed. It's great for the small green industry businesses. Again, it can make yourself look bigger. And that's the best thing about all the social media sites. It can make you look bigger than you actually are. And it really can. And it can make you look a lot more professional than you actually are. Several things like that can help. And what you want to do is I mean, because a lot of us, we operate out of our homes. We do. And there's nothing wrong with that. But you can make it look like you have a corporate office if you want through social media. And then there are different software options for you to blog. WordPress is a good one. My website, turfteacher.com, is a WordPress site that allows you to do, change it and put graphics up and stuff like that. And it does have a blog section to it where I can actually start doing the blog. And actually, the blog, it almost kind of reminds me of like a Twitter feed. But you can type, big articles or just, a few, one paragraph if you want to. But people can always go back to your blog. They're dated and then they're put in like month categories. And so you can say of, May of 2017 or June of 2017, the articles and stuff would go in these folders per se. And there is the blog from my website that you guys have already seen. This, you went here, you clicked courses to sign up for the online courses. But the blog, it's right here. And I just put up Turf Teachers on Snapchat. For all you on social media, you can follow Turf Teacher on Snapchat. Continue reading, talks a little bit more about it. But I posted that on February 7th, 2017. And that's letting everybody know that I am on Snapchat. Blogging again, free information. That's what we want. Don't use blogging to market your services. Use it for information and nothing else. Get the customers and potential customers coming back. Talk about plants. Talk a little bit about plant science. Talk about what makes the leaves turn colors in the fall. Talk about monoecious or dioecious plants, things like that that people think, pretty cool. Well, hey, why does one holly have berries and the other one doesn't? Well, one's male and one's female. Talk about that, explain that. And people like learning about that. People love to learn. So give them the information. Hire it done if you can't do it. Again, if you're not going to do it, it's better not to have it. Or if you want to do it and we all wear too many hats as business owners. Hire it done. Have somebody in the office. The secretary there that's answering the phones or returning emails for you in her spare time, she could do one blog a week. And you don't have to blog every day. You don't have to do that. Maybe once a week, write a little article. Find some information on it, give it to her. They've been trained, They may have gone and gotten an associate degree or something in office administration, so they've had to write papers and take English and stuff like that. Let them do it. But we have the knowledge, the expertise, and we have advice for people. Don't sell it to them. Give them those three things: knowledge, expertise, and advice, but no sales on your blog. YouTube. Again, you're watching a YouTube video here. That video that we saw on Socialnomics was a YouTube video. Market your organization to millions of people. No big budget required. All it requires a cell phone camera and a little creativity. Or you can get a little handheld and come back and do it to your computer. It's totally up to you. If you're doing it on your phone, not only need the YouTube app, but download the YouTube Capture app, and that'll actually record that video and actually post it to your YouTube page. You want to inform. You want your company mission and values. What do you do? Put that all in a video. Educate, how to, or a service demo. How to study more effectively. How to correctly prune crepe myrtles. Perfect opportunity for those of y'all that are like me and think it's, awful to crepe myrtle those beautiful Lagerstroemia indicus. Take a video to showing them how to correctly prune, or go find some that are destroyed by it. Take a little video. This is why we don't crepe myrtle. So follow me over here. I'm going to correctly show you how to kind of thin out the crepe myrtle and dress it up. We don't want to top it. Educate the people. Again, free information. And then entertain. Show off your past events, your work, behind the scenes of running a green industry business. Again, I still people would love that. They're going to be like, wow, these guys and gals are up at 5 o'clock in the morning. They're rolling into the shop at 5:30, especially the business owner. Because our crews get there sometimes 6:30, 7 o'clock. So we're there beforehand getting stuff ready. Let them know what we do and really what it's like to run a business. Link the channel to your main homepage or website, Facebook, LinkedIn, your professional blog, tweet and update about your videos. So if I put up a blog or if I put up a YouTube video, it's going to go to my Twitter. Or if I don't post it to Twitter, I'm at least going to say, hey, you know, just put up a new YouTube, check it out, and then put a link to it. And then focus on your search engine optimization, optimize the video text and descriptions with keywords and links back to your homepage. Again, brainstorming about those hashtag words, those at symbols. All right, another brainstorm. Hey, take out a sheet of paper. I want you to think of some jobs or activities that you or your company has done that could have been recorded. So, you may have just done a super nice koi pond. You may have just done a super nice retaining wall. Take the camera out there or your phone and see what could video. We just did this project at Mr. and Mrs. Smith's home. We used such and such block. It took us 3 days to complete this wall. Our clients are so happy. And hey, see if you can interview the client. Yes, I'm Ms. Smith. We hired ABC Landscaping to do this retaining wall. We love it. We cannot wait to show it off. We did it so we could put some vegetable gardens up there on the hill. We used that that space, and Mike and his team were so wonderful. We recommend them. Write down these jobs. What have you done that you could do a video like that? Again, it's free advice or a portfolio. Free advice or portfolio. You're giving them knowledge, but you're also bragging about yourself. And it's okay to do that. Write these down. Last exercise is to find me on the social media. Turf Teacher on everything, guys. At symbol Turf Teacher for Twitter. YouTube is users /user/ Turf Teacher. Facebook's Turf Teacher. Snapchat's Turf Teacher. And Instagram, Turf Teacher. And you can see that the Twitter handles all have the at symbol in front of them. And Instagram's big on the number symbol or the hashtag. And also that works on Facebook as well. So, all right, do that. Follow me on the social media sites, guys. And then we will have a quiz at the end. All right, and that wraps it up. Again, this is the six most favorite social media sites that Turf Teacher loves. YouTube, Twitter, Instagram, LinkedIn, Snapchat, and Facebook. So, guys, I appreciate you joining me in this lecture. Hope you have a great day, a great week, and a great season. And Turf Teacher out.